Good morning, dear writers. So yesterday I taught you so many important things. They are very important for one marks question. Like what is the gold number? What are the protective colloids? What is the Hardison's rule? All those things just remember. Now today I am going to teach you the emulsion. Almost we are reaching to the completion point of this unit. So the last one is the means before this one, after this one. There is one more thing, that is the application of colloidal solution or application of colloids. So here, before that one, emulsion is also one of the topic. So what is the emulsion? Already you know the definition. It is the liquid-liquid colloids. So what is the meaning of liquid-liquid colloids? Means the colloids in which the dispersed phase and dispersal medium both are liquid. That is known as liquid-liquid colloids. Now the best example is milk, hair cream, medicines. These are the examples of emulsions, liquid-liquid colloids. Just see in the milk, what is the dispersed phase here? In the milk, dispersed phase is fat globules, and dispersion medium is water. Dispersion medium is water. And now try to understand, there are certain terms which are given in the emulsion topic. What are the emulsifying agent? Emulsifying agent. Sometimes what is there? We add certain substance to stabilize the emulsion. What is the meaning of this one? Sometimes we add the substances to stabilize the emulsions. So those substances which are added to the emulsion to increase their stability or to stabilize them, they are known as emulsifying agent. Just try to understand. In the milk, what is there? There is no need to add. There is one natural protein, name is casein. That casein is helping in the stabilization of milk. How these emulsifying agent work, we'll explain the role under the heading of role of emulsifying agent. But always remember, emulsifying agent may be added from outside or may be present in the substance itself. Just like in the milk protein casein is present. So dear cadets, now examples of emulsifying agent. So what are the examples of emulsifying agent? So solution acts as a emulsifying agent in eye and water colloids. Casein, that is the milk protein, acts as a natural emulsifier. Just see, in the milk what is there? Fat globules are there. They act as a dispersed phase. And milk means water present in the milk, that will act as a dispersion medium. So this casein protein present in the milk, that act as a emulsifying agent there. We'll tell you the role of emulsifying agent. Some other examples of emulsifying agents are gum and gelatin. Okay? There is one more term, emulsification. What is emulsification? It is the process of preparation and stabilization of emulsion by the addition of emulsifying agent. What is emulsion? It is the process of preparation and stabilization of emulsion by the addition of emulsifying agent. Means the process of preparation and stabilization of emulsion by the addition of emulsifying agent, that is known as emulsification. What is the demulsification? Demulsification means demulsification. The meaning of this one is separation of dispersed phase and dispersion medium from the emulsion, that is known as demulsification. Means breaking back the dispersed phase and dispersion medium from the given emulsion is known as demulsification. Now we'll tell you the role of emulsifying agent. So just see dear cadets here, role of emulsifying agent. So actually, do you know what emulsifying agents are doing? Just see, Emulsion is the liquid-liquid collides. Two collides are there. That emulsion can only be sterilized when dispersed phase and dispersion medium both are intermixed with each other. Okay? But there are certain liquid-liquid mixture which do not mix with each other, as ice in water. Do you know that ice will never mix with the water? Ice will never mix with the water. But if some drop of its source solution you add, then that same ice will dissolve in the water. It will intermix with the water. So who is playing role here? Here, source solution is playing the role. And what is the function of source solution there? We'll explain it. Just see, source solution, the moment you add to the ice in water collides. So these soap solution, as you know, soap has got two parts. What are those two parts? Hydrocarbon part and hydrocarbon part, that is the tail part, that is hydrophobic part. And another one is the non-hydrocarbon part, or that you can say the ionic part, and that part is soluble in the water, hydrophilic part. You know everything I taught this one. So hydrophobic part, that is the tail, hydrocarbon part, that is soluble in the ion. So that will cover the hydrocarbon part of soap, will cover the ion droplets. Okay. Now hydrophilic part of the soap, they will mix with the water. So just see, soap has got two parts. Half part is intermixed with the ion. Remaining half part is mixed with the water. And what was your emulsion? Ion in water. So just see, ion and water, they were not mixing with each other, because at their interface, F-A-C-E, there is one surface tension. What is that one? Surface tension. Because of that surface tension, ion was not dissolving with water and water was also not intermixing with the ion. So the soap will reduce the surface tension which is present between two liquids layer, interface. So now what is the work of your soap solution here? The work of soap solution is, that is the emulsifying agent reduce the interfacial tension between two liquid, thereby they increase the solubility of dispersed phase and dispersion medium with each other. What is the emulsifying agent? Emulsifying agent reduce the interfacial tension between two liquid, thereby they increase the solubility of dispersed phase and dispersion medium with each other. So once the surface tension between two liquids are reduced, both will intermix with each other. And by which means, because of whom they are doing this one? Because of emulsifying agent, they are doing this one. So this is the role of soap solution in ion in water. So once again, soap solution, half part, that is hydrocarbon part, will intermix with the ion. Remaining half will intermix with the water. So just see, whatever surface tension was present between ion and water, because of the soap solution, they are breaking. It is reducing. So you can say emulsifying agents are the mediator. They are joining two liquids with each other. Are you getting my point or not? I will give you the simple example. Suppose X and Y two persons are there. Okay? X and Y two persons are there. Both are not talking with each other. Okay? In between, one person A came. Okay? Who is talking with X also and Y also? So, since X and Y communication gap is there, so the person A can communicate with each other. Whatever X will say, he will convey to the Y, and whatever Y will say, tell or say, he will convey to the X. So he is the mediator or not? Same way, if two liquids are not intermixing with each other, so emulsifying agent, they are such kind of agent which are dissolved, intermixed with the both kinds of liquid. That is why they reduce the surface tension and both liquids can intermix with each other. Next one is role of casein protein in milk. Just try to understand. You know that in the milk, what is there? Dispersed phase is fat globules, and dispersion medium is water. Okay, and here what is the casein here? Casein is here emulsifying agent. What is this one? Emulsifying agent. What is this one? Casein is here emulsifying agent. What casein will do? Casein will deposit at the surface of, it will cover the fat globules. Generally, what is there? Fats are insoluble in the water. Okay, fat globules are insoluble in the water. Now casein protein will cover the surface of fat globules. So now what it will do? That casein protein is soluble in fat also, soluble in water also. Then what would be there? Along with the casein, now fat globules will also be soluble in the water, because their outer covering is now made up of casein protein. And you know that casein is the natural emulsifying agent. So in this way, emulsifying agents are acting the connective link between two insoluble liquid, that is emulsion, and because of them only emulsions are stabilized. Just try to understand. The meaning of emulsion is not that dispersed phase should be separate, dispersion medium should be separate. They should be intermixed with each other. If they are intermixed, then only they will be called as liquid-liquid collides. If they are not intermixed with each other, they will not called as a stable collides. Okay? So here the role of emulsifying agent is very important. So now, dear cadets, now types of emulsion. There are two types of emulsions. Okay? The first one is I in water. So what is this? Is also abbreviated as OW type of emulsion. Here what is there? Just I in water means I is dispersed phase and water is used as dispersion medium. What are the examples? Mustard oil in water, kerosene in water, petrol in water, and the best example is milk. Okay, so just try to understand. Oil in water, so since water is here dispersion medium, and you know the dispersion medium is always present in the excess quantity. What is there? Excess. Okay, and oil is here in less quantity. So on the basis of dispersion medium amount, they are known as aqueous emulsion, because water is more. The next one is water in oil type. Here you can write water in oil type, and here what is there? Water in oil type. Okay, so this is also abbreviated as WO type emulsion. Here water is dispersed phase, and dispersed phase is present in less quantity. So water is here less and oil is here in excess quantity, because it is a dispersion medium. So who is highest here? Whose amount is excess here? Oil amount is excess. That is why it is known as emulsion. What are the examples of this category? Butter. The best example is butter, cod liver oil, cold cream. In cold cream, what is there? Name says what is there. Rest everything is a oily part only. In butter also, what is there? Mostly water is used, little bit water, but most of the thing is fat only, oil only. Okay. So these are the examples of water in oil. As far as diagram is concerned, you can make diagram. Just see. This is one beaker, okay? I in water. So everywhere what is there? Everywhere what is there? Water is there. So write here water. Water as a dispersion medium. Dispersion medium. And this one. What about this one? This, and this. What is this one? This is I. What is I here? Dispersed phase. Okay. I hope that these things are visible. So these droplets are I droplets. What about this one? Water in I type. Just reverse of this one. This is beaker. Okay. Now here everywhere what is there? I. Because I is present in excess quantity. I. What is I here? Dispersion medium. Okay. And this droplets. Now the sum drops of water. What is this one? Water. What is this one? This is dispersed phase. What is this one? Dispersed phase. Okay. So this is the diagram. So basically there are two types of emulsion. I in water type and water in I type. With the examples I told. Just see in the milk what is there? Less amount of fat globules are there. And fat or I is there, dispersed phase. And the rest of the part is water only. That is the dispersion only. Same thing in the butter. In butter what is there? Less water. More I. More fat. I cream, cold creams, less water, more I are fat. So these are the examples. So dear cadets, now identification of emulsion. How you can identify the emulsions? There are two types of emulsions. I in water, O W type. And another one is WO type, water in I. Okay, so just see, there are two tests for the identification of emulsion. The first one is the dilution test, second one is the dye test. Just see, with the help of these two tests, very easily we can identify that what kind of emulsion we have got or we have been given. Just see, first one is the dilution test. So just try to understand. Water is added to the emulsion. Okay, what is the first step? In dilution test, whatever emulsion you have got, just you add the water. Okay, when you add the water, then what would be there? If water is used in that emulsion as a dispersion medium, then what would be there? Dilution will be taken place. Dilution will be taken place means the amount of dispersion medium will increase. Means given emulsion is now diluted. So what is there? Water is used as a dispersion medium there. So what kind of emulsion that is? That is I in water type of emulsion. Because water is used as a dispersion medium. So I must be used as a dispersed phase. So if dilution takes place, that is O type of emulsion. If dilution does not take place, what is there? Dilution does not take place. Means water is not used as a dispersion medium. Rather, I is used as a dispersion medium. Whatever water you will add, if I is used as a dispersion medium, so added water will be present as a water droplets there. Because water will not be soluble in the I. And I you have used as a dispersion medium. So what kind of salt that one? What kind of emulsion that one? That is WO type, water in I type of emulsion. So this is all about the dilution test. What about the dye test? You know what is the meaning of dye? Dye is nothing but a colored organic compounds. What are they? They are colored organic compounds. Okay. So the oil soluble dye, you have to add to the given emulsion. Okay. Now just see. If colored droplets are appearing. appearing in the colored droplets are appearing in the emulsion. So what is the meaning of this one? Since added dye is soluble only in the eye, so only droplets, colored droplets are appearing. Means eye is used as a dispersant. Entire medium has not become colored. Only colored droplets are produced. It means eye is used as a dispersed phase. Since eye is used as a dispersed phase, that is why it is eye in water. O W type of emulsion. Now suppose entire background become colored. So dye which you have added, that was eye soluble. So when entire background only become the colored, it means eye has been used as a dispersion medium, and water is used as a dispersed phase. So that is W O type, water in eye type. So everything I have written here. Eye soluble dye is added to the emulsion. If emulsion is having colored droplets, it means eye is used as a dispersed phase, and this is O W type of emulsion. If entire emulsion becomes colored, it means eye is used as a dispersion medium and it is W O type of emulsion. So in this way the identification of emulsion can be done. So in this way entire emulsion is completed. Now applications of emulsions. So just try to understand what are the uses of emulsions. There is no need to teach the uses of emulsion again, because just I will remind you under those headings you should write. So what are the uses of emulsions? Just see. Try to understand. Uses of emulsion. Okay. So what is the first use of emulsion? In cleansing action of soap. What is it? In cleansing action of soap. The first application is this one only. In cleansing action of soap. I don't think there is a need to teach this one again, because I have taught this one in very detailed manner. Okay? That is the first use. What is the next use? Next use is in milk. Okay? Just see, if casein is not present in the milk, then what is there? The moment you get the milk, all fat produced will come at the surface. Because fats, they are not soluble in the water. Because of casein, only that fat globules are soluble in that. So they are also role is there or not? What is the third role? In medicine. There are so many medicines which you are getting in the form of emulsions only. Especially in the Ayurveda, there are so many medicines which you are advised to take in emulsion form only. So these are the some uses. Other uses are also there. Just try to understand. Now, if you want to make the solubility of eye in water, then some drops of sugar and soap solution you should add. So these are the some applications, and you can do this one. Now only one topic is left, that is the application of chlorides, which I will complete in tomorrow's video. Till then, bye. Thank you. Hoping that you are doing the things. Thank you.